did you feel? Tell me how you were feeling in the finals. You know, as the race is winding up, what were you thinking?
Yeah, well, I just knew that I had to be prepared before the race to make the decision at the moment where it got really tough. I mean, I think that's the key in any championship race, is that you decide you're going to endure when it gets hard. You know, before the fact, so that it's automatic. So it's definitely like visualizing that moment. And I was really focused on the final and just staying relaxed on the inside, because I made a few tactical errors in the prelim and did quite a bit more work because I was on the outside lane, or this lane two. So I just was focused on getting in a rhythm and staying relaxed and being really ready for that move. So I felt that way, you know, that I positionally had a good spot and that I was ready to just react.
So you had a great finish, just shy initially of making the team, and then was it a phone call? How'd you find out?
Right. So, so I was fifth like I was 2 years ago. It wasn't quite as close, but I honestly was really kind of at peace with however it went. So I was waiting to see if I knew that Molly Huddle, the woman who won, was going to forfeit her position in the 5K, but we were waiting on Emily Infeld, who came in fourth. So I was told that she would make a decision before the end of the night, and so I went back to the hotel and went through team processing as an alternate. And so this is like probably a couple hours later. I'm going through the stations as an alternate and just doing my thing. And then her coach came over with his cell phone, and my coach was on the phone, and he wanted to be the one to deliver the news that Emily had given up her spot and that I was on the team. So it was, you know, I think it's still sinking in for me. It was like an emotional moment, but I didn't really receive the information. Like, I wasn't crying, or, you know, it was like an amazing gift, but at the same time it was just like so much at once that I don't think I could fully process it then.
So what's going on right now? What's happening in your life right now?
I'm just getting consistent training in. I'm in Boston. I've been in Boston since the final. I came home the day later, and just training until I leave on Monday, on August 1st. I'll go down to Houston for some team processing, and then right down to Rio in time for the opening ceremonies.
Yeah, envision that. How have you been doing any sort of trying to see that at the end of the, what's going on right now about being there?
Yeah, I think I'm most excited for the opening ceremonies at this point. It seems like it's obviously closer, it's next week. But I've just been told that moment is really, really special when you walk into the stadium and see your flag being raised. I think that's when everything will sort of come together and feel more real. So, that's going to be amazing. And just to be among other athletes, you know, from other sports, and to be able to stay in the village with them and just kind of take in that environment without, you know, letting it become overwhelming. That'll be interesting, and just good practice. You know, hopefully there's an opportunity like this again in the future. So
tell me about first of all, your Dartmouth connection. Explain to me that you're about the coach now helping you. Is your coach from Dartmouth? If you could tell me that.
Sure. So my current coach with New Balance Boston was my coach at Dartmouth. So that was just an incredible blessing to be able to kind of streamline my transition to professional running by having, you know, that's one of the hardest parts of that change. So he accepted the position January of my senior year. And that was around the same time that I was starting to look at, you know, the prospective options. So he's amazing. We've been working together for about 6 years now. And it's cool to just, I think he's meant to coach elites. So, you know, we have a smaller group now, more intimate, you know, more individualized, and we're really privileged to work with New Balance. It's amazing and be close to home. So I really feel like it's a good fit.
Give me a sense of your Dartmouth friends and family and their reaction and the support you may have felt, because you had an amazing college career. And here you are, now headed to the Olympics. How has your Dartmouth family been? What's that been like?
Yeah, well, that support is still so invaluable, because I feel like in a lot of ways that's where things really began. Like, I began running in high school in my freshman year. But my relationship to running was so different then. It wasn't until college that I, you know, began to realize my potential. And you know, was just like growing up as a person. And to hear from people who have been there kind of every step of the journey is just like, those are my best friends. And a lot of them are actually in Boston. I've been able to see them in person since. So yeah, I mean, those are, of course, you know, lifelong relationships. And just that sense of camaraderie in the team, like, that doesn't go away. With athletes of even, you know, different event groups, like, we were tight, and the captains really made it that intentional. So yeah, I've been just talking to people from all over.
Anything I didn't ask you about how you're feeling going into the games, how you feel physically, mentally? Is this kind of the centering time? What kind of workouts do you do now? And you know, less than a week you'll be there, so.
Right, right. Well, it's so interesting. You know, I've talked to a lot of people and they're like, you're an Olympian, like, this changes your life. And like, it's an amazing blessing, but it doesn't change my life. Like, that's a big takeaway. You know, like, I am, it's a part of me, but it's not who I am. You know, it's not my identity. So it's kind of liberating to think about it that way. Like, nothing has to change for this event. You know, it is a special opportunity. And it's not to be taken lightly, but it's not like absolutely earth-shattering, groundbreaking, you know. And it honestly is liberating to think about it that way, because it can be a pressured, you know, event. So yeah, I'm just excited. It's just getting out there every day, like I said, being consistent and having gratitude for the experience, and just like, you know, sharing it. It's like it's a huge platform for reaching other people. Youth, and like, that it's bigger than just your performance. It's a lot bigger than that.